Welcome back, everybody, and I have to start off with an apology. Yes, this is another episode of Beholder, and if you did watch the last one, you've seen me get stabbed in the stomach multiple times. Now, I am technically safe scumming right now because I did reload the last save and I decided to give him the money in order to, well, not get stabbed 15 times. This allows us to keep going with the story, and I want to know how the story ends. I hope you guys want to know that, and this is the fastest and easiest way to just see the story happen. And yeah, it's no longer Iron Man, as you can see, but yeah, it's... we'll have to learn to live with that now. I think I have to look at... can I just call the ministry right now in order to not get stabbed? No, I can't. I have to look in the box. That's... Now, I took the pistol the last time, but I didn't get the... I didn't get to defend myself with it, so... No, mother. Honey, your daddy needs to get stabbed right now. Learn what happened? I don't have the box. Really? Give me that damn box or you'll be sorry. Why can't I give it to him now? Like, why isn't that give him the goddamn box that's in the office kind of... We'll have to give him the money. Damn you, deal. Can I use them to buy what I need to on the black market? A good deed won't be finished because of you. How can I make the world a better place if I can't trust anyone? I think I want to take the gun. We can plant it on someone. And then we can still maybe give the weapon to someone. Pick up the phone. Accept the protocol. Good afternoon, Carl. This is George Danton. Where did you take my number? Our unit has friends everywhere. All I want from you is an explanation about which unit you're discussing. I have a family. I must know what you're getting me into. I'm trying to make the world a better place, Carl. It's impossible with the current government. As you know, the current government is unwilling to change. What's your unit's name? Unit of Confident Revolutionists? The New Tomorrow Movement? Why are you being sarcastic, Carl? We might have become best friends. You can earn the money you so desperately need for your family. What if I refuse to deal with you and report you to the quarters? I am afraid your refusal can lead to unpleasant consequences for both of us. I repeat, we have friends everywhere. I knew it. There is something behind your chat about a better tomorrow. One can't fry eggs without breaking them. Either there's a team missing here, or you, sir, need to learn how to cook. You have kids and therefore must know what it means to sacrifice yourself for the sake of future generations. Will you offer to sacrifice someone else? Me, for example? Not necessarily, Carl. You just need to agree to be ready to help our movement. I really don't have a choice. What do you want from me? Find an apartment in your wonderful building for our faithful comrade. His name's Antoine Grubig. He will stay in the building for about a week. Let's say I agree. How much will you pay me? 3,000. Dude, I just gave your fucking kid 5,000 for not stabbing me. This will be the beginning of our collaboration. Who's that? Antoine is very important to our unit. He's a printing specialist and will print brochures criticizing the current state government. We'll owe you if you hide him. We're planning to go on strike in the factory in the near future and need the brochures. It won't work without them. Danton. You know my daughter is sick. She needs medicine. I can't get here. Liebe Spirit, can you get it? No problem, Carl. As soon as I understand, I'll give the... Oh! Agree to help. I'll see what I can do. What I'll do is, I'll take this one. Hello, this is Costine. With whom am I talking? I've heard about the National Labor Lottery. You've heard about the National Labor Lottery, right? It's when Leon Griffith is looking for a place to stay. We want you to refuge to this lucky man. What good will that do you? well wishes. He'll soon face 1,000 temptations. Bandits and frauds will be waiting for him around every corner. We want to help. After he moves in, you must convince him to invest his winnings in our production. Our horns and hooves trust benefits, the science of breeding and caring for farm animals. We help farmers sell every part of an animal carcass. They don't waste a thing. We send the meat to the stores and the skin to the shoemakers, and we use the rest of preparation for preparing our proprietary jellied meat. Jellied meat? Do you not like jellied meat? How can one say? Consider this a warning call. If somebody stands in our way, he becomes jellied meat himself. Soon our jellied meat will become a national good. All you need to do is convince Leung that the future belongs in jellied meat. Yes, but who thinks up such names? It's a real tongue twister. Persuade him to invest money in the Horns and Hoof Trust. If you do that, we'll give you a generous portion of what he gives us. I have 2 apartments, so... Oh, there's a lot. So, I got a call about him and about him. Don't know about her. I don't know about her. I don't know about him. In 4... Did I just click on 4? I'm not sure. In 4, I have... I repair 1. That's amazing. Unfortunately, I don't think she's moving out. I need to evict her somehow. In apartment 1... I definitely have cameras, and I want this guy, because I want to spawn him. And I do have 4, so how... I have cameras in 4, so how about we do that? And in 6, we can get her. Thanks, Carl. I'll send the money to your account. Please help Comrade Grubik the best you can. He's doing an important thing. Help us and spy, do you understand me? Yes, I understand you. I never doubted you. I'll call you in a couple of days to see how you're doing. No. We had a deal about your medicine, and if you don't want me to freaking rat your kid out, you better get me the medicine for my daughter. Okay, no one wants to talk to me at this point. Is she here right now? Because if not, I'm gonna plant something on her, and I'm gonna... try to evict her that way. Like, I don't want to kill her. Okay, she's here. Let's get away from here. I don't want to kill her in my house. So. Oh. I see it, and guns are illegal. Why can't I see that? I'm Carl, the landlord. It's nice to meet you. A mutual friend told me you're one of the best printing specialists around. It seems you mixed up some things. I don't think we have mutual friends. Of course, secrets and other stuff. Sorry for bothering you. I don't know what you're talking about. Can't I just... What are you talking about? I mean, this one. Small task. I decided to complete at home. Don't worry about it. It won't disturb the tenants. Rosa, how are you doing? Sorry about that. So she likes a drink from time to time. I kind of want to say hello to her, but I think she's leaving right now, and I'm going to use... Oh, I don't have cameras to put in her apartment. I'm Rovina Patrick. I finally found a good apartment close to the plane. I work on the and grow very tired, so I don't have the energy community. I hope you like it. Me too. And I'm working. They work great. I check the meters constantly. Why do you ask? I work at the plant and like putting mechanisms together. Don't freak out if the apartment starts to smell like solar. Thanks for telling me. We're gonna come here, but it's an interesting job. What exactly do you do? I assemble the engines for the appliances the state puts in its apartment buildings. You must think that's not feminine, but there are a lot of women at our plant. We host appliance assembly competitions, and a woman broke the record in the laundry machines category. Interesting. Of course it's laundry machines category, right? Do you by chance compete in soup making contests? Very funny, Carl. Male humor? If housewives governed the country, people wouldn't be hungry. Because you'd make soup, right? Our shift manager is a woman too. She's thinking of becoming a politician. I like male politicians, who are unpleasant. Female politicians are simply disgusting. Why? Because, just like Santa Claus, they're imaginary figures in our country. You reason women are so broad. They're completely out of line. Your chauvinism is making my head hurt again. A headache or typical? Go away, Cole. Why am I such a bastard? These guys were clever ones. Only once or twice this week. It's going to get really cold soon. I hate fall. It's my migraines. Because of the weather? No, because of the migraine. I don't think we'll be best friends. Oh no, he's gonna need money again, right? Why does everyone always need so much goddamn money from me? Oh! Just got this and this and... I need to talk to him. She's out of the house right now, so I kind of want to use that. Wait, that was an illegal object. Oh no, my daughter's reading. Fish is illegal? I must have missed that, but... I think this is her... So he's doing something. Nice, I got that. So I did find her passport, which is nice. She's not in the here right now. Oh, and again, I can buy this and this, so I can't spy on her properly. That's good. Oh, there's the trader, but I still don't have enough money. I could buy radio, but I think the medicine is more important. We can have a quick look at how much the radio costs. Oh, I hope that's not her. My son. He wanted something before, but he doesn't anymore. I hope that's not a problem. Oh, there he does. She's super sad. Yeah, that's straight. Take a look. I could sell the gun. Oh, that's actually worth quite a bit. I think I want to buy an apple. I can use it to blackmail people. She has migraines. Maybe I should buy an aspirin for her. I'm sure she'd be grateful. What else was I supposed to... A radio was 2000. Yeah, I'll manage somehow. Stop reading stuff like this. Meet. Hi, my name is Colin, the landlord of the barn. I thank you for taking in more tenants. I'm Leon Grishnik. I will be here for a few days, attending an important matter. How? Who brought you to Helmholm? I feel fortunate for the first time in my long, difficult life. I won the labor lottery and have come to the awards ceremony. Oh, she was gone. This was my chance. Tell me she's going to eat something. Damn it. I want a red heart. I think I get money for that too. Learn what happened. Hi, Dad. We need to talk. I'm thinking of leaving the country with my girlfriend. Wow, who is she? Why do you need to leave the country? Is she pregnant? Do you realize it's hard to leave the country at the moment? Hold on, Dad. I don't even know where to start. Her name is Andrea Gorchik. Why are you telling me only now? You never asked. I never said. She's a professor's daughter. And what's the reason for this sudden departure? Are you in trouble with the law? Her father, he's been stalked for years and he's innocent, I swear. They found out something threatening has been uncovered. That means he's a criminal. He has nothing to do with this, Dad. I swear, his enemies have been filing false complaints about him for years. Her family needs to leave as soon as possible. And I should go with them. She means the world to me. See... There's a problem right now, if you ask me, and that is... I love her. He wants to leave the country with wanted criminals, if I understand that correctly. So even if I love my son and everything, I don't think you should go with him. And you're too young to make decisions that could change your whole life. Every teenage love lasts forever. Dad, you met Mom when you were only a year older than me. Yes, and we dated for 3 years before getting married. Oh, you'll break your mother's heart if you leave. How much do you need? We'll still need money to cure Martha, you know? 10,000. Sorry, man. They look like the Minister of Finance. When am I supposed to get that kind of money? Print? 10,000? I hadn't even seen that much money at your age. I've never even seen that much money at one time. Yes, you did. You just paid it for medicine. Dad, I don't know what to... want to cause you trouble. If you can't fund the money, I don't know what I'm going to do. What should I do? Okay, let's deal with this issue in the order of their appearance. How much time do I have? 2 days? Or they live without me. And I'll never see my love again. Jeez, okay, I need to think. Don't do it, man. Just don't. I'll blackmail him. This is the kid that, that took the 5k from me, right? Joy, little bitch. Wait. No, the kid's gone. Damn it. Okay. I know that he... he's Antoine Grubik. He lives in apartment number 1. He's done the Apple thing. Well, he didn't, but I did. And it's from here. I know this. Send. And actually, I will profile some tenants. I did see a few things about some of the people. Her I'm going to evict somehow. I can't keep doing this to her. Oh, I can profile him. Mark Rannick. Lives in apartment number 3. He's male. He's this. Like, I don't even think I'm doing something bad here. I'm just telling them what they want to know. And, this isn't good that I'm doing it, but I'm not hurting anyone. I'm going to report this as well. She's... Noelle, she lives in apartment number 5, female, she lives alone, she's a music teacher. There's a bit of money to be made here. Anyone else? Do I know something about you? Yeah, I mean, I can profile. Oh, and I can blackmail her. That's awesome. It's just fish, so I don't think that makes her particularly dangerous. She lives in 6. What's the fish? How much is the fish? 48 from the 8th. This actually will set me up with enough money to pay for the medicine. Haha! Gotcha. I want to talk to her, but... actually, I want to talk to him. He has... what do you want? I need a help call. I have to go to the administrative office tomorrow. There's going to be an award ceremony. I'm a simple man, I work at a factory, I've never owned a suit. I bought a 2-piece suit at the funeral shop, but there were no ties. The department store is also out of ties. Could help, but they're illegal. Everyone will be okay. I just can't go shopping. I'll try to give handles on. I'll pay you. The ties are illegal, man. You need to know that they're illegal. Talk about the lottery. How are you spending your winnings? I have a difficult dilemma. My sister's house burned down recently. She and the family live close to the front line. I want them to... but I have no family. My co-workers are my family. I'm also going to buy new work shoes and a case for my tools. I'm buying gifts for my niece and nephews. I found a shop where you can buy honey cockerels and cranberries with sugar. Great deal, I love cranberries too. Remember, you can only buy 2 packs at a time. 2 packs? That'll make a few trips. There's so many barges loaded down with coal. Isn't that amazing? I think what I'll do is, probably I have to get him the tie and then he, I have to find, get him the money and then he can, then he'll listen to me when I tell him to invest in, I think it was some meat, some juiced meat or something, Okay, it's gone a bit overboard. I wonder how often I can blackmail people until they decide that I need to die. Like, I want to be stabbed again. Okay, she's leaving. There must be something incriminating in here. The problem is I don't have an apple anymore. Oh, he's leaving. I can take the apple. I put it in his apartment and put it in her apartment and just get rid of her that way. I think that's the easiest way. And then I have an apartment friend I can get some interest, because I think her story is done. I'm stuck with her now. So let's do this. And she's coming back. Is she going to the bus or is she going home? He's here. I can buy the medicine. He didn't call and I don't trust this. We're running out of time and I don't want to risk not having the medicine. So I will buy it. Honey, now you have to love me. I'm sorry, but I got you your freaking radio and I got the medicine. I got my mother's. I beg you, can't find the medicine. Here it is. Are you crazy, mother can barely stand? What? I found Deep Spirit. The pure spirit. Really? Carl, I'm sorry. I was wrong about you. Oh, but you'll finally get well. I must get her the medicine at once. Actually, on the way to the medicine thing. Oh, she doesn't want to talk to me. Oh, the woman is leaving. He's waiting. Yeah, this is awesome. I'm going to plant the apple and I'll have her arrested. I'll get a bit of money for it. And I don't even think I need to plant any more things. By now, so many things are illegal. I'm sure there would be something in her apartment illegal. But let's steal the sleeping pills. I'm sure sleeping pills is because she has trouble sleeping, remember? Maybe I can give them to her. Do I want to black? No, I want to report her. She's not Sarah Wetternacht. I don't know why she's written like that. Yeah. Listen, apartment 2, violated number 39 from the first. I love how like 90% of my reports are just people eating apples. And the funny part is that all of it was fake, except my family actually ate apples. So we're the only ones that actually did the bad thing. I can give my wife the radio. You bought a radio? I've already chosen a spot for it. In your office. I did. Stop nagging me, Anna. Here's radio. Thanks. Fairy tales for kids. Make us that, but we'll listen anyway. Why does it have to be in my office then? I think we'll make a quick cut here. I hope you enjoyed this episode again. I think we'll make this one a bit shorter. But again, I didn't set my timer. So I'm not 100% certain how long we've been playing and I don't want to go overboard again. So I hope you enjoyed this one. I am still very much enjoying this. I don't know how long this will keep going. To be honest, I still like it. But I am at a point where I hope we're coming towards the next conclusion. Anyway, I'm enjoying this. I hope so do you, and we will see each other in the next episode. Have a great